Okay. So let us continue with questions on composition scheme. One or two questions I am taking from CA Institute module, and then we will rework your CMA questions. Okay, we have to change a lot of things from your CMA questions. But this is the latest amendment that composition dealer earlier was not allowed to supply service. Now he is allowed to supply service. This is the provision explained here in detail. Alright. And this is the limit I told you, 10% of turnover in state or 5 lakh, whichever is high. This is the maximum service he can supply. Based on that, there is one question, so through question we understand it better. Ram Sevak is engaged in supply of goods. So his main activity is supply of goods. His aggregate turnover in preceding financial year is 60 lakh. So he is eligible?
Yes.
Yes, this is last year turnover, so he is eligible in current year because his turnover does not exceed 1.5 crore. Okay, you have to write 1.5. So why not 75 lakh? Why didn't you say 75 lakh? For 75 lakh, they have to mention that he belongs to special state. Alright, if nothing is mentioned by default, he belongs to rest of India. Alright, so the limit we will take 1.5 crore. Since his aggregate turnover in preceding financial year does not exceed 1.5 crore, he is eligible for composition scheme in current financial year. Further, in current financial year, he can supply services up to value not exceeding, come on, tell me, 10% of last year turnover. And last year turnover was 6 lakh or 5 lakh, whichever is higher. So, maximum services that he can supply in current year is 6 lakh. Sir, what if he supply more than 6 lakh? Then he is not eligible for composition scheme. He has to follow normal laws. Am I clear?
Yes.
So this is the one thing that we have discussed. Now, one small question. A taxpayer, Tola Ram. So Ram is there everywhere, you can say. No, Ram, Sevak, Tola Ram and all that. Just a coincidence. So a taxpayer, Tola Ram is a manufacturer. So he's a
manufacturer.
What is the tax rate for manufacturer?
0.5
CGST, 0.5 AGST on total turnover. Okay, total turnover in state. He is having one unit in Uttar Pradesh and another unit in Madhya Pradesh. The moment I say Uttar Pradesh and Madhya Pradesh, some students say it's interstate. It's not interstate, it's a multi-state.
Yes, yes.
Yes or no? He can have multi-state, no problem. He should not have interstate. UP should not sell to MP.
Yes.
Or UP should not sell goods to any other state. Mm. Yes or no?
Mm.
Alright. UP is selling goods in UP, MP is selling goods in MP. That's no problem. Okay, it's okay. Can I go ahead with this?
Yes.
Okay. Total turnover of two units is 115 lakhs. Okay. 85 lakh and 30 lakh. You tell me. Eligible, if it is the last year turnover, eligible?
Yes.
Yes, because total turnover is less than 1.5 crore. And current year also no problem. Total turnover of unit A1 and A2 in first quarter. Why quarter? Because he pays the tax quarterly.
Yes.
Composition dealer pays tax quarterly. 18th of the following month. 18th of the following month. That we have discussed. Okay. First quarter was 5 lakh and 10 lakh respectively. So one unit is having 5 lakh turnover and another unit is having 10 lakh turnover. So on this 5 lakh, how much tax should be paid? UP 5 lakh. UP? 5 lakh. No? UP turnover first quarter is 5 lakh. So how much tax should be paid? 0.5 CGST. They have given here together, but you should not write like that. 0.5, that means 2500 UP GST and 2500 CGST. Are you getting this?
Yes.
On this 10 lakh, 0.5 MP GST and 0.5 CGST. Total will be 5000 and 10,000. 1% tax. Am I clear?
Yes.
Easy?
Yes.
Yeah, this type of questions should be asked from composition scheme. Now let us go to your CMA module question. We have to redefine question, redefine answer. Okay? So, I hope it is readable, right? Example 93. I'm taking example 93. Okay? Messes X Limited being a manufacturer of laptop. Laptop is fine, right? Which products are not fine? Ice cream, pharma, sarva, and tobacco products. Okay? And have 4 factories in Chennai, Salem, Coimbatore and Madurai. Geographically, these all branches comes in Tamil Nadu. Okay, these are Tamil Nadu areas.
Yes.
So, can he have multiple branches in one state?
Yes.
Yes, no problem. He can have multiple branches in multiple states.
Yes.
He should not have interstate supply.
Yes.
Am I clear?
Yes.
Yeah. language that they have given us turnover, which is including taxes. Now, including taxes turnover, we should not count. We should count excluding taxes. So please use your calci. And they have given us this total turnover. Can you see total 111.51? Can you just compute and tell me what is the turnover? This is including. How to do it? 111.51 divided by 118 multiplied by 100 is equal to
94.5.
So eligible or not eligible? Is in Tamil Nadu. What is the Tamil Nadu limit?
1.5.
Eligible or not eligible? Obviously it is eligible. Okay?
Yes.
Obviously it is eligible. Yes. Now when they have written eligible, no, your model have used word, okay, does not exceed 1 crore. Why? Because the previous limit of composition scheme was 1 crore. So in answer, what will you write here? 1.5
crore.
So this is the amendment we have to do. Did you change the answer?
Yes.
Sure? Can I go ahead?
Yes.
Next. Paul Limited being a trader of laptop, trader of laptop. What is the difference between manufacturer of laptop and trader of laptop? Trader has to pay tax only on taxable income. Okay?
Yes.
Trader of laptop has two units in Chennai. Chennai and Mumbai. Chennai is in Tamil Nadu, Mumbai is in Maharashtra. Can he have two different states?
Yes.
Yes, no problem. Okay, he should not have interest. And turnover wise, which limit is applicable now? Why? Because Tamil Nadu also in 1.5 crore and Maharashtra also in 1.5 crore. So no confusion.
Yes.
Am I clear?
Yes.
Yeah? So Chennai is having 52 lakh and Mumbai is having 12 lakh and this is excluding of taxes and we wanted excluding of taxes.
Yes.
So very good. So tell me, eligible or not eligible? What is total turnover?
64.
64 lakh. Eligible or not eligible?
Eligible.
So they are asking, eligible for composition current year? Answer is yes.
Yes.
Why? Because he, hello? Why? Because his turnover, aggregate turnover on PAN basis, aggregate turnover on PAN basis does not exceed
1.5
crore. They have written 1 crore in answer,
yes.
We have to write 1.5 crore. Then they are asking, second question, I hope you will give me right answer of second question. They are asking, can he opt composition for Chennai and normal scheme for Mumbai?
No.
He has to opt for all units composition scheme. Okay, so he doesn't have choice for opting a composition scheme for selected units. Okay, so the answer is given there. That answer is right. No, Mr. Paul cannot opt composition for one unit and normal for another. Am I clear? This is answer. Third question. Need to give separate intimation. Is it required to give separate intimation? If I have 5-state operation, do you think I should give 5 application in 5 state? No, if I give 1 application in any state, it is deem application for all state. Because I told you, if you apply for all. If you withdraw for
all.
So that is also procedural aspect also they have given. Okay, can I go ahead?
Yes,
sir. Message X and company sells electric cables, motor and wires. Company also undertake repair is
service.
Repair is service. Here they are selling these items and then they are repairing the item. Okay? The total turnover during the preceding financial year is 59 lakh. Whereas the repairing is only 1 lakh. So is it eligible or not eligible? What is the answer of your institute? Not eligible. But this is old answer. Why? Because in last year service was not allowed. Right now is it allowed?
Yes,
it is allowed. How much it is allowed? Up to 10%
of
turnover or 5 lakh, whichever is higher. Obviously it is just the 1 lakh. Eligible or not eligible?
Yes.
Eligible. Yes or no? So this answer is wrong. Right now the answer is yes, eligible. Hello? Are you getting this? So this is the amendment we have to do. Eligible. Why eligible? Because he can supply services up to 5.9 lakh or 5 lakh, whichever is higher. Why? How 5.9 lakh? Because it is
59
ka 10%. Okay. Can I go ahead?
Yes.
So this answer we have to change. Next. Similar, every time we have to change answer. Whenever service has come, your model has written not eligible. We have to write yes eligible. Okay. But limit. Obviously we have to check limit. Mr. Q is a paper merchant, owns 5,000 square feet shop in Chennai, and he is supplying, listen, Mr. AQ offered extra space available in their shop to a supplier to put up their advertisement. Advertisement is a service.
Yes.
Alright. So what your model will say? No, not eligible. Okay. His turnover in a previous year from sale of goods was 20 lakh and advertisement service was 2 lakh. Is Mr. Q eligible for composition scheme in current year? Answer
yes.
Is?
Yes.
Yes, because he can supply service. Up to that you have to write. If you don't have numbers, you have to write 10% of turnover instead or 5 lakh, whichever is higher. Eligible. Right now it is eligible. So this no answer is wrong, now answer is yes. Subject to it not providing services exceeding 10% or 5 lakh, whichever is higher. Now, Hotel King Private Limited provide restaurant service. Restaurant is there in composition?
Yes.
At what rate? 2.5. But do you remember non-eligibility?
Yes.
If you are supplying product which is not leviable in GST, supplying product which is not leviable in GST, then are you eligible?
No.
Answer is no. Answer is no. So they are selling whiskey and listing. Okay. Beer and whiskey. Now beer and whiskey is excluded from section 9(1).
Yes.
Alright, alcoholic liquor for human consumption.
Yes.
So these people are not eligible because they are supplying non-leviable goods. They are supplying
non-leviable
goods. So they are not eligible. So the answer is right now. Hotel King is not eligible for composition scheme since they are supplying the product which is not levied under GST. Or not in the name? Alcoholic liquor for human consumption. Okay? They have written whiskey and beer. Can I go ahead? Easy question. 98. A of Chennai is a retailer dealing in a cell phones. He is dealing in cell phones. He supplies goods to a person located in Chennai. He is located in Chennai and he is supplying goods in Chennai and Pondicherry. Oh,
no,
Chennai and Pondicherry. Chennai to Pondicherry, state to union territory.
Yes.
State to union territory is interstate supplier. Interstate supplier is not eligible for composition scheme. Am I clear?
Yes.
Easy? Can I go ahead?
Yes.
Next. Peter England is a trader who sells ready-made clothes online on Amazon India. Online. He is selling goods through e-commerce operator.
Service.
Eligible or not eligible? We have written in eligible, no? Supply of goods through e-commerce operator is not eligible. Am I clear? So he is not eligible. E-commerce operator. Next. Hot Breads Private Limited is a supplier of bakery product. Registered in current financial year. In the month of October 2017, total taxable supply is 88 lakh. Answer following. Is company eligible for composition scheme? You please ignore dates, though dates are old dates.
Mm-hmm.
Alright. Follow current year dates. Okay. So 88 lakh. Last year turnover is 88 lakh. Eligible or not eligible?
Yes.
Eligible. Why? Because it is less than
1.5.
Am I clear?
Yes.
Yeah. Next. If company wants to pay tax at 1% being a trader, company wanted to pay tax at 1%. Alright. Because they are a trader. Trader means 0.5. Last year it was 2%. Now, right now it is 0.5. However, Deputy Commissioner of Central Tax contended that assess is liable to pay 5% because it is a food and restaurant service. They are selling bakery item. In bakery, do they serve you like this?
No.
So is it restaurant service or sale of bakery items?
Sale of bakery items.
So it is a trader, 5% is not applicable, only 1% is applicable. And 1%, their 1% is wrong. Here the answer, in answer, see they have written 1% and 1%. Okay. So this 1% is what?
0.5
CGST plus 0.5 AGST. Am I clear? Yeah? So technically it is like that. Alright. Next, Hotel King Private Limited is registered under GST with a turnover 100 lakh. Last year turnover is 100 lakh. Applicable GST rate is 18%. Okay. Input cost is 7,80,000. Input cost is 7 lakh. They are hotel. What is the rate of composition? Composition rate of hotel? okay? And if you don't want composition, then 18%.
Yes.
Normal rate is 18%, okay? Input cost is 780,000 exclusive of 18% GST. So this is exclusive of GST. When I buy, I have to pay GST.
Yes.
Hello? And I told you two things very clearly at the beginning. If I get credit of GST, GST is not a part of cost.
Yes,
it's set off is available.
Yes.
But if I go for composition, can I take credit?
No.
No, I cannot take credit. That means GST will become part of cost.
Cost, yes.
Am I clear?
Yes.
Credit nahi mila to it will become part of cost. Alright? Profit margin is 40% on cost. So we have to add 40%. What are they asking us to do? Very beautiful question. This is like final level question. CMA final level question. Alright. Find the invoice price and advise the best option to pay tax, if any. That means we are doing tax planning here. Hello? Assis is asking us, sir, should I go for composition or normal? You cannot just close your eyes or toss the coin and say, okay, composition.
Yes.
Alright. You have to show him calculation. Sir, if you go for normal scheme, this is the tax you have to pay. If you go for normal scheme, this is the tax you have to pay. Composition versus normal. You have to show two calculations to them. Okay? So this, can you remember the data?
Yes.
His total turnover is 100 lakh and input cost is, that means he is eligible or not eligible? Less than 1.5 crore. Eligible, no?
Yes.
Yeah. So current year his cost is 7,80,000 plus 40% if you do, it will become your selling price.
Yes.
Okay? Now let us see how they have done it in two options. Okay?
Composition
maybe. Cost of input is 7,80,000,
yes,
but you have to pay along with GST 18%. So this is 18% GST on 7,80,000. Can you check these numbers from Kelsey? 7,80,000 multiplied by 18%.
Yes.
Yeah?
Yes.
Plus equal to
9,20,400.
This is my total cost. Why it is cost? Why GST has become part of
no
cost?
Input.
Because I am not getting input tax. Because I am a composition dealer. Okay. Now I have to add 40% of margin. So into 40%. That will become 3,60,160
yes,
plus equal to.
Yes.
So I will sell it at 12,88,560. On this, I have to pay 2.5% CGST and 2.5% HGST. To multiply by 2.5%.
32,214.
So this tax I have to pay. What is my total liability then? Multiply by 2, you can do. 64,428. Am I clear?
Yes.
Easy? This is composition liability. If I am a normal provision, then what will I do? Cost of input 7,80,000. And I will not add 18% of GST as a cost. Why? Because that is available as a ITC. So my cost will become 7,80,000. Profit margin is 40%. So multiply by 40%. 7,80,000 multiplied by 40%, 3,12,000 plus equal to
10,92,000.
Huh?
10,92,000.
Yes or no?
Yes.
They have not written. 10,92,000. Mm-hmm. Yeah? Multiply by 18%.
1,96,560
plus equal to
12,98,560.
This is my invoice value. Okay?
Yes.
So what is my liability then? 18%. No, this is 18%. 1,96,560 divided by 2. CGST and HGST, right?
Yes.
So how much is CGST?
98,280.
Am I clear?
Yes.
Is it right?
Yes.
280 is right?
Yes.
Yeah? And I had input. Input of 7,80,000. So do this 7,80,000 into 18%. That number was already there with us.
1,40,400
divided by 2.
70,200
CGST liability credit and 17,000 AGST credit. Yes or no? I will subtract this credit.
2,880.
Output liability, input credit. Are you getting this?
Yes.
So net I have to pay only
2,880.
The total liability will be 56,160. You tell me which scheme is better for dealer?
Normal
scheme. Yes or no?
Yes.
But problem with normal scheme is this. You have to comply with all provisions of GST law.
Mm-hmm.
Monthly return, monthly payments. Hello? Are you getting this? Detail record.
Mm-hmm.
So everything normal will happen. It's okay not to save tax. If you can save couple of thousands, like here you are saving almost 20,000 tax. You give 2,000, 3,000 to one cost accountant. He will come and he will handle this job.
Yes.
Yes, sir? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Better?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Next. I told you don't read your legal content because it is amended now. This is very old content. Okay, so for reading you have to download concept from ICA module from ICA website and then read it from there. If a person is liable to be registered on 11th October, has applied for registration on 17th October. So this is the registration question. Hello, this is? Listen this, so this question will be over. If I cross turnover of 40 lakh in Maharashtra as of now, or 20 lakh for service provider, it is 20 lakh for goods, it is 40 lakh. In Maharashtra, limit is 20 lakh and 40 lakh. For service provider, limit is 20 lakh. It's not that everybody need to get registration under GST law. Hello? Everybody need not to get registration under GST law. If your turnover exceed 40 lakh, then only you are liable to take registration under GST. That means small, tiny persons are not required. So, paanwala, chaiwala, vada pav vendors, if their turnover, official turnover, does not exceed 40 lakh, they are not supposed to take GST registration. Therefore, that tea vendor is not charging GST on us.
Yes.
Hello? He is not registered. Why? Who is giving him power to not register? GST law itself. Because he is selling us commodities up to 40 lakh. Government have given him choice. If you want, you can get registration. If you don't want, you don't want to. You should not get registration. It's not mandatory for you. Optional, but not mandatory. Are you getting this? Today, that trader is crossing 40 lakh. Now, today he is eligible. He is liable to get registration. Yes or no? This is question from registration chapter. Not at all anything to do with my composition. Just question has come. Therefore, I am telling you this concept. So today I have crossed this particular turnover. Do you think today only I should close my shop, run and get registration today itself?
No.
No. Today I crossed it, so it's okay, you become eligible. You find a cost accountant or chartered accountant, you go to him, give your document, he will apply it online. Online procedure will take 3 to 7 days to get registered. Hello? So registration will come in future date, yes or no? So here what has happened, on 11th October he was liable to get registered. He got registered on 17th October. Okay, they are saying his registration is valid from which date? So 17 October when he got actual certificate in hand, or 11th October when he was liable to get registered. So there is a condition in registration chapter. If he apply for registration within 30 days, within 30 days, then registration will have retrospective effect. Registration will have, you understand retrospective effect? So although he has applied on 17, 20, 24th, he applied within 30 days, no?
Yes.
So his registration will become applicable from retrospective, that is date on which he became liable to get registered.
Yes.
So his effective date of registration is 11th October, because he applied within 30 days, because he applied within 30 days. What if he doesn't apply within 30 days? Then effective date of registration will be date of registration. Effective date of registration would have become data. What if he apply for 15th November? 15th November is not within 30 days. So the registration, whatever registration date he gets, that date will become effective. Hello? For retrospective application, you need to register within 30 days from the date of becoming liable to get registered. Am I clear?
Yes,
sure? Can we go ahead? Yes, so that is just a separate, your module is doing this like fun part with you. You know, this is just enjoying you. They are putting question from any chapter anywhere. So he can apply for registration on the date of registration itself. Not that important. Next. Some forms and all they have given. Practical problem 106. Sitaram. Again Ram. I told you. Somewhere it is getting connected. I don't know how. Okay. Sitaram is running a consultancy firm and also a ready-made garment showroom. The problem is that he is having service and
goods.
Alright. As per your model, answer will be no.
Service.
But as per new law,
yes.
But subject to his service component should not exceed 10% of aggregate turnover of last year. Yes or no? Or 5 lakh, whichever is high. So Sitaram running consultancy firm and ready-made garment showroom, registered in same PAN. Turnover of the showroom is 60 lakh and receipt of consultancy firm is 12 lakh in the preceding financial year. You are required to answer following question. So this question is not relevant as of now, but still we are going through it. Is he eligible? So your module will write no, but we will write yes. But we will put those limits. Okay. Next, where it is possible to opt composition scheme only for showroom? Like they are asking, they are having two division, no? So can he apply only for showroom and not for consultancy?
No.
No. If he apply, then he has to apply for all business. All business that is running on his pan. Rework, if Sitaram is running a restaurant as well as ready-made garment showroom. Now restaurant is restaurant and garment is garment, both are eligible for composition. No problem. He can opt for composition. But on garment, he will pay 1% GST. On the restaurant, he will pay 5% GST. Okay, next. If the turnover of garment showroom is 75 lakh in preceding financial year and there is no consultancy firm, can he take, is he eligible for composition scheme? Only garment, 75 lakh. Yes, because if turnover does not exceed
1.5
lakh. Question number 107, please delete. Because it is a repetition, just. No, not really. You can read. If current year he is selling alcohol and all, just a repetition, no, that risky question. So, question was not relevant. Next, Mr. H is registered in Hyderabad. Hyderabad, Hyderabad comes in which state? Andhra or Telangana? It comes in Telangana, I guess now. Okay. Who is selling goods from Telangana to Tamil Nadu? Bangalore they have clearing. Telangana to Tamil Nadu. So it is what? Interstate, no? Interstate, so? Eligible or not eligible? Okay. The turnover is not important, no? It is interstate. Next. Turnover of Mr. Roy in preceding financial year is 49 lakh. So eligible?
Yes.
Mr. Roy has opted for composition scheme. So he opted for composition scheme. And during the year on 18th Feb, what has happened? Now 18th Feb 2019 you can make here. Okay. 18th Feb 2019. Turnover of Roy exceeds 1.5 crore. We have to redefine question itself. Turnover of Roy exceeds 1.5 crore. What compliances are required to carry by Mr. Roy? Can he continue composition scheme?
No.
He has to, composition scheme will lapse by default and then he will become
normal.
That note we have written. Roy is required to do following compliance. What? File form GSTR CMP 4 within 7 days before 21st. That form numbers and all they have given. And details of stocks and capital goods on 18. This we are going to anyhow discuss in our input tax credit chapter. This question is from input tax credit chapter. Hello? Okay, ITC chapter. Next. 110. Mrs. X Private Limited is manufacturer having two units. Unit A in Andhra Pradesh and another unit B in Tamil Nadu. Andhra and Tamil Nadu. Two different states?
Yes.
Possible?
Yes.
Same question I showed you from ICM module UP and MP.
Yes.
They have the US Institute have just changed name. Balance question is same. Hello?
Yes.
He can opt for composition. He has to pay Andhra Pradesh state. Andhra Pradesh GST and CGST. And Tamil Nadu GST and
CGST.
Only thing is that you have to change in this answer is they are taking 2%. Why? Because earlier rate was 2%. Now we have to cut this and write it 1%. So it will become 0.5 and 0.5. Am I clear?
Yes.
Hello? So that change also you have to make here. And finally we reach to our chapter exemption. But before that I have to teach you one more scheme from ICAI. Presumptive scheme. Yeah?